destroying the world.
Praise the Lord. I'm sure that some of you didn't take your tea this morning, and you're looking for the breakfast, and you're saying, what is the breakfast? We want to have something. Okay, you're going to have it in a couple of minutes, but you just have to just cool out a bit, and you're going to hear what we are sharing and what we want you to believe, because this breakfast is the second in a series of monthly interdenominational prayer breakfast that the Lord laid on my heart when I came to Las Vegas in January this year to bring the men together. Two things the Lord said to me about this city of Las Vegas. People need to come together to prayer.
That's right.
And the men need to come together to focus on Him so that they can change their attitudes towards work, towards wealth, and towards women.
That's right.
Wouldn't that be a nice thing, ladies, if men could change their attitude towards women? Okay, these are three things that the Lord laid on my heart, and I began to work with them. I visited a number of churches and shared this vision, and that is why this morning we are here in a second breakfast, because I believe that men need fellowship. Men need a fraternity where they can come together and share with other men. And therefore, this is what this breakfast is all about. To give you the opportunity to come together and share. We're going to be fellowshipping in a while, and we're going to be making sure that each one knows someone. So if you have a calling card, a business card, you make sure you exchange it with someone. Make sure you meet some ministers here. We've got a few of them here on the head table. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We've got about 9 ministers here this morning, and therefore we want you to meet them, because this is all about unity. Because the word, the early church was successful. Why? Because they were all together in one accord. If we are going to take this city of Las Vegas for the Lord Jesus, we are going to have to move out
one accord
in unity. United we stand, divided we fall. We have been divided and have been competitive for too long. Now is the time to break that breach and to come together as one. Because when we go to heaven, the Lord is not going to ask for the Episcopalian church. He's not going to ask for the Baptist church. He's not going to ask for the Pentecostals. We are all one in Christ Jesus. And that is why we have to begin to do that down here. Okay?
Amen.
So we have to, so the purpose of the breakfast is to bring men together in a fellowship so that we can talk about things that's going to make changes in your life. Alright? I want you to say after me, today
is
the beginning
of
the balance of my life.
The information I receive
will help me
to change my attitude.
If I change my knowledge,
I can change my thinking.
If I change my thinking,
I can change my speaking.
If I change my speaking,
I can change my actions.
If I change my actions,
I can change my habits.
Isn't that wonderful?
Amen.
Change begins in each one of us. And as you see, the theme for this breakfast has been, if you're satisfied where you are, here is not the place for you. But if you are looking for change, because if you change, you can improve. You can only get better as the time goes by. Okay? So we're talking about change. And last time, I talked about a number of things, and I just want to just verify some of the things that I spoke about last time. Last time we said that if you are going to make any change in this life, the first thing you've got to do is to understand that you have to set a goal for your life. Isn't that so? And if you don't set a goal for your life, you would not know where you are going. Because if you don't settle to go in a particular direction, any road will take you there. As a matter of fact, have you never been going in any journey and you didn't know when you were going wrong? When you got lost and you didn't even know that you were lost? But when you understand the first and most important thing, that you've got to set a goal for your life. Because if you don't set a goal for your life, any road will take you there. So it's important that you set a goal. And then there is the next most important thing that you've got to understand, that you've got to learn to make decisions. Now we as men have been thought of as not being able to make decisions. Isn't that so, ladies? Yeah, don't answer now. But I know that very often it is said that men are irresponsible because they can't make decisions. Therefore, it's important that we as men learn to make decisions. We have to be decisive about where we are going, because if you don't make a decision, you will not be decisive about where you're going, and as a result, you are not going to be able to reach that target that you set. So you have to set a goal for your life. After making that decision to go where you want to go, you've got to recognize the importance of solving problems. Each of us have been placed here on this earth to solve a problem. And it's important that we learn to solve problems. So problem solving is important, okay? Now, if you don't learn to solve a problem, it will be solved for you. Because you didn't make a decision doesn't mean that nothing would happen. No, because if you don't solve the problem, somebody else is going to solve it for you. So you have to learn to make decisions and to solve your problems. Now, those are minor things that are just in the mind. You've got to make some shifts in your mind. But then there are other things that are important. Time management. Now, we were supposed to start this breakfast at 8:30, and by 8:30, we didn't have enough people here, because it's a habit, it would seem, and people just come in late. So we got to change our thinking on time management. We have to learn to manage our time, because time is money, all right? Therefore, you know, so don't let us waste it. Let us use it to the best of our ability. So we have to learn to manage our time. And after learning to manage our time, we have to learn the next step is what comes after time. Since time is money, we have to learn to manage our money.
Amen.
That's important. You know, because if you don't manage your money, you're not going to get very far in life. You're going to spend on things that you see that you don't really need. So you have to learn to manage your money, make a budget for yourself and for your life, and write down the things that you need to spend your money on, and not just spend it at the sales. Now, why do you think every time you go to your post office box or even to your home, the postman brings a lot of extra literature? And there's a word that you will see on all that literature. S-A-L-E, sale. Every time they're encouraging you to spend your money on sales. And you know the thing about sales? Very often you do not need the item that they are projecting, but you just buy it because it's cheaper than it was yesterday. They had it at the high price. And while they can't get it sold at the higher price, no, it's at the lower price. But all of us have got that mentality that when we see that word sale, we are to make a beeline for that place. You know? And that is the problem. So we are not able to manage our money because the money we had budgeted for things that month, we could not use it. And now the first thing you need to do is to give God his due. Once you give God his due, he is going to make sure that the other things will fall in place. So it's not like the shortchanging God to make things go well for you, okay? So, and then after you've learned to manage your money and you recognize, look, I have got to spend my money according to what I need and not what I see. Now that's very important. When you learn to manage your money and spend it on what you need and not what you see, you are going to come into a different relationship with your spouse and with your family. Men, sometimes men are said to have spent their money before they got home. And when they got home, they wasn't able to pay the bills because the wife has the budget, but you have the money. Well, you see, that's going to be a problem. So we need to be able to work together with who has the budget. You know what I mean? Not because you have the money you must spend it, but you must know how to spend. Manage your money, okay? And then you've got to learn to communicate. Communication is vital, it's important. So many relationships break down because we do not communicate. Therefore, we have to learn to communicate, all right? Because if you don't communicate, if you don't say what's on your mind, nobody will know. Nobody are mind readers, especially your spouse, those in the church, those at home, nobody will know. So you have got to learn to say what you mean. Communication is very important. And finally, interpersonal relations. Now, a lot of you know that we need doctors, we need lawyers, we need the bankers, we need these people, don't we? Yes, we do. But the thing about it is, if they're unmannerly, if they're discourteous, if they, you know what I mean, if they're unfriendly, it does not help. So the last thing you need to understand is that we need to have good interpersonal relations with each other. We need to be able to speak to each other, because we have to make friends with each other, because we have to learn to love one another. Because Jesus said, it's in John's Gospel chapter 13, verse 34 and 35, a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if you have what?
Love.
Love one for another. No, you see, we sometimes try to think that we must love God and not our fellow man, but that cannot work. Because the only way you are going to prove your love to God is by loving your fellow man. So we have to learn to reach out and have interpersonal relations with each other, which is going to take us through. Because each of us have emotional needs. And these needs must be met here on this earth. If you look around, the first emotional need that every human being will have is a need for attention. You know that? Every one of us like somebody to pay some attention to us. And therefore, that's the first emotional need. And if you need it, somebody else needs it. So make sure you look this morning for somebody, you pay attention to somebody, okay? Then there's a need for approval. There's a need for acceptance. There is a need for affection. There is a need to be able to appreciate another person. Because if you don't appreciate people, despite what you do, they like to hear you say, thank you. It's well done. I love what you did. You have to learn to appreciate what people have done. And of course, there is the need for us to recognize the importance of looking at people and not only accepting and appreciating them, but admiring them. And that is important. Admiration is important. You have to learn to admire. So you've got to start admiring your wife in the home. Admiration is the next emotional need. And then there is a need for affirmation. You need to affirm those around you. Let them know that you love them. Let them know that you care for them. Let them know that you love them. So these three words are important. I love you. Those are words that help to affirm your spouse, etc. So we want you this morning to be if you. That's the first question you need to ask yourself. Who am I? You, if you are a child of God and you are made in His image, then you are important. So you need to tell yourself, I am important because I'm made in God's image. And secondly, you need not only to be able to say that, but you need to understand, why do you exist? Why do you exist in life? Do you ever ask yourself that? Why do you exist? You exist that what your mind can think, your hands can create. Every one of us exists to be creative. There is something created that every one of us can do. And therefore, we should not be looking to the other person, but each of us have been placed here in this world to develop our potential, to be able to move forward towards our purpose, and to be able to establish what is it God has given us to finish our God-given destiny in this life. That's why we're all different. God is not going to ask me about you or you about me. He's not going to make any mistake with who we were, because there's a DNA that tells who we are, even when we are dead. You know, there's a DNA that, and there are methods of identifying us. And if there are these methods of identifying us, then we have to recognize that we are important. And if we are important, we have to begin to behave like we are important. Men, I want you this morning to take a look at yourself, a different look. And first realize that you are important. And if you are important, it is time that you understood that you cannot behave the way you used to behave before. Because in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17, it says, any man in Christ is what? A new creature. All things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Alright? All things have become new. Therefore, we have to work on changing our attitudes, all right? Because, like I said, if we change our attitudes towards work, you're going to work to make money for yourself. So actually, you're working for yourself. Now that is something that you need to think on, because a lot of people think they're going to work for the boss. No, you're going to work for yourself, all right? Secondly, I want you to understand that wealth is for all of us, because Jesus died that we should become wealthy. The wealth of the righteous, of the wicked is laid up for the righteous. And it's God's will that we become into wealth. But you know something? We need to understand the whole purpose of wealth. We could not hold this breakfast this morning without money. Therefore, we have to appreciate what the word says about money. The Bible says, money answereth all things. Without money, we cannot do a lot of things, okay? Therefore, you have to stop thinking that, okay, I don't need too much money. No, you need money. Somebody said, well, doesn't the word say that the love of money is the root of all evil? Yes, the love of money, but not the use of money, all right? So I just want you to understand and appreciate that if you're going to come into wealth, the whole purpose is you've got to ask yourself, do I want to look wealthy or I want to become wealthy? Becoming wealthy is a process. Looking wealthy is just buying expensive clothes, buying expensive cars, but then you're not fooling the bank managers, nor the people who own the credit cards. They know that you are not wealthy. Because if you're coming into wealth, you're coming into a process where you are going to work, you're going to save, and you're going to invest your money. So those of you who cannot save, I want you this morning to think seriously. That change must take place in your own lives. It must begin in you. And you have to change your attitude even towards women. You've got to learn to admire and appreciate them. You've got to learn to say positive things to them. You've got to learn to help them to be what God would have them to be. So this morning, I want to challenge you. Are you ready for change? Are you? If you are ready for change, then today is the beginning of the balance of
put your hands together.
To make
your Lord the harvest, and we worship you. We worship.